week. These are my ideas of how we're going to be right, exactly. So this is kind of like a sink or swim for me. So if it's not working out, I'm going to change how they write it down and how they are implementing it. For right now, I think this might be the easiest way for them, just writing it down and seeing visually if they're meeting the standards or if they are exceeding the standards
as
well.
What are you doing for the kids that, what are your plans to do with the kids that don't have the technology at home?
Well, they can do it during center rotations, or hopefully teachers will allow them to do it after school, because a lot of my kids do stay after school. I only have two that don't. Yes, Ms. Ellis.
Sometimes what I do, because I have several students that don't have access to technology, you can also print out a lesson like Ms. Moorhart showed in her activity.
Printing out the questions.
Right. You can print out the questions and have them do it on paper. Or either, like you said, when they come in the morning or they have that free time or that room available, then they can do it in class. But I don't penalize the students who don't have the technology. But several parents are like, I don't have a laptop. I don't have anything.
But then you have to take the scores and plug them in manually, correct? In order to track their progress. So yeah. You have to practice that pretty often.
So, Ms. Nelson,
yes.
You don't. So this is outside. This is what you require outside of what you guys do during the school day.
Right.
Okay.
So this is just going to be, I might even have the same standards during class and after school. Mm-hmm. Just the more practice that they had increases their level of the academic standards. So even if like one or two of the standards are the same during my center rotations, it's not going to matter because I still have students that are at 50, 60% for some standards and I need that to be raised. Mm-hmm. So the more they work on it, the better they're going to get for that part.
And then when you see that they have academic morning in certain areas, you like use them, that small group to teach them.
Yeah, so and then that'll help me regroup my kids when I regroup them like every 2 or 3 weeks. Like right now, I'm regrouping them for next week already. So in that way, I can focus on, like you said, I have a small group attention where I'm working with 3 or 4 kids for 10 or 15 minutes for math and reading. So that'll help me know what tools I can use for them. And a way that they get motivated is the blue ribbons. So on the back, I simply just copied and pasted a bunch of blue ribbons, and in the hallway they have a chart. So every Friday I print out a blue ribbon report, which is like the second report under school. And during their morning work time, the first thing they do, I print out the report Thursday, and then Friday morning before they start their morning work, they're going to color their ribbons that they earned and post them on the chart outside. And then I'm trying to think of like some reward or something that if they get a certain amount of ribbons, like stickers or moving them on a pin chart or prize box. So they love to do that and see how many ribbons they earn for the week. And even if, they can see on here when they earn ribbons and they tell me all the time, it's not safe. I got a blue ribbon, woo! So,
you could also invite the principal down, give me a heads up, and then I could do something that would be a reward. I'd be happy to do.
Perfect. Yeah, so I just print out this report every Thursday, and in my data binder, I have how many they earned the week before. So let's say Larissa earned 5 ribbons last week. I know just to give her 2 more. So I'm keeping track myself on a different chart how many they earned. So, and then I have to print it out for first grade and kindergarten too, since some of my kids are on the lower level. And then that's basically it right now. So if you guys have any other ideas for how to track their data, that would be good. Because this is kind of just a trial and error for me right now and the kids themselves. This binder, is going to go with them to the computer lab, going to go with them to their centers and home with them so the parents know. They have the website, they have the data, because I had parents coming up to me asking about Accelerated Reader outside. Mm-hmm. So they're also going to be tracking their books and their percentages and everything.
Do you have
like
a
that.
Little, maybe just a little signature thing so that you know the parents are even looking at
right.
it? That would be a nice thing to have. Maybe they could sign off on it every week.
For sure.
Or
yeah.
So, I think this is a good idea.
It gives them ownership.
Right. Mm-hmm. And because when the kids are on the computer and they see their 80% or their 60%, they kind of forget about it after. So this way they can see their growth and see where they're going and hopefully getting to higher levels of learning for them.
And Elsie's Blue Ribbon Picto inspired me, and we were talking about yeah. using it as a school competition. So I asked her to create this huge, because she's very talented. And we're going to discuss how to make it a school competition, a Blue Ribbon Study Island school-wide competition.
Well, don't mess up my AR stuff. It's a party.
It'll go away from that.
Super Reader or Fantastic Reading, all different kinds of tags. Mm-hmm. And if you wanted, for example, if you call me down, I could present that to the kids that do something special. So if that tickles your fancy, come down and see one of us, and maybe we can figure out something we can do to celebrate, because I think the kids might like that kind of stuff. It's like a medal. And there are actually some medals there, too.
Do we do award ceremonies here, just like small little kind of
at the end of the year? That's too long.
That's too long. I agree. Maybe each quarter, even if it's just shown improvement.
Sure. And then those kids who got medals, maybe the next thing you make sure they have them, you bring them up in front of the group.
Definitely.
And bring them up into the circle of honor, which we have a few of them.
That definitely would be a motivational factor.
Seriously.
Yeah.
Because it's like, oh man, I'm
and so next
And another thing that I could even do this, my friend, she gives her kids beads, and they are just obsessed with collecting like those little beads. If they read for like every 100 minutes, I think they read, they get a bead on like a necklace or something like that. So even if it's something
That's
as
cool.
cheap as that, every ribbon they get, if they get a bead on a necklace, they can hang it like on the outside of their desk, and that's also another visual way that they
cool.
can see.
I've seen that work with high school cross-country team members. It's a stupid little lanyard that's homemade, and there's different colored beads that are very carefully selected for different people. And they will do anything, legal or illegal, to get those beads. So if you guys come up with a system, I'd be happy to support you. I could be excited.
The NAR schools also that I'm hearing about, making t-shirts to celebrate.
That's cool.
Well, thank you, Alfie.
Yep, good job. What? No, I have it on the table, so I'm okay. I'm trying to build up my muscle strength. No, I that's why I decided to put him on the table.
Yeah, we've done something.
Were you familiar with Study Island before you came here?
No.
Mara, were you?
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
All right, I am talking about the data and how I use it in the classroom. And I've used it in quite a few ways. The first thing that I do is I bring the kids into the computer lab twice a week, and they, I don't like me to do it.
I'm sorry.